All right, so the issue that I'm having is this here. Let me explain it first. This is about a 2016 Exmark E-Series laser, 60-inch cut, and it's a 27-horse Kohler engine. What I've had to do at the end of last summer, it was starting to act up. I've got 3,800 miles on, or hours on it. 3,800, that's way further exceeded for this thing. Usually guys are getting rid of these things or rebuilding the motor or whatever. 2,000 hours at the most. I usually get around 4,000 out of all the mowers. The other two that I have over here are, they hit about 4,000 hours and I put new motors in them. This one here is still the original motor. I've had to do a few things to it. Gaskets, you know, simple things, gaskets. But this one here is bigger. I'll tell you the problem I had having and how I noticed it. I would have to, it started stalling at low idle. So I had to rev it up a little bit just to keep an idle going. Of course, when we're mowing, we're at full throttle and you can't tell a difference. Other than it's really going through fuel fast. So in order to get it on the trailer, normally we'd bring it down to idle position and just drive it up into the trailer. Well, it wouldn't sit there and idle in low position, so low throttle. So I had to keep it in high throttle, get it up into the trailer, low throttle it, turn it off with a key. And when I did that, I noticed a spark behind me. So I did it again, the next job, and what it is, the spark that I saw inside the trailer is actually a flame coming out of this muffler. It's about 2 feet long, and it's crazy because I store the gas, or the fuel tanks in the trailer just behind this mower. So obviously that's a problem. So what I had to do is start figuring out, I noticed gas was dripping from inside, you know, around the filter somewhere, the air filter, down below where it attaches to the carburetor. So I knew I had, there was some problem. So I started poking around and I started messing with the gas on off valve coming from the fuel tank on this. So I would turn the gas off, then I could idle it down and it would idle at low throttle. Get it on the trailer, shut it off, no more spark. So obviously it was getting too much fuel. So one afternoon I came home, pulled it all off because it was still getting, I noticed, you know, when it was dripping that fuel, I wanted to take that off and see what's going on. So I tested it and everything, cleaned out the needle valve, the float, the bowl, and it looked like the needle, everything's bouncing correctly. Put it all back together, get out to the job, still doing the same thing. Flame coming out the back, wouldn't low idle. So it might be worse. So what I'm thinking is I'm gonna take the carburetor off again right now. We'll look inside of it, and it's where the needle, you know, the float pushes the needle up and closes the valve where it seats at the bottom of that carburetor. I don't think it's seating properly. Obviously it's not, because gas keeps coming through even at low idle. And it keeps dumping out and excessive fuel getting in there and it's blowing it out the back end. So it's not good. It's not good for the motor or anything. So I'm trying to avoid buying a new engine this year. If I can get one more year out of this motor, it'll put us over, well, around 4,500 hours. So let's get this off, this carburetor, and see what it looks like at the mating surfaces where the needle's supposed to go up and it's either dirty in there or there's something in the seat where the needle goes that's, it's not true anymore. It's probably pitted or corroded away, or you know how gas is. This machine does not get non-ethanol, and I still get, you know, 4,000 hours out of it. So let's take it apart and see what we got. Looks like these are 10 millis. Yep. Gotta get this air cleaner out of the way first so we can get back there and see. It's got four of these. Two on this side, two on that side. And then it's got this tube right here has gotta come out just like that, so. All right, now we should be able to wiggle this up and out of the way. Yep. This is the fuel line coming in, that's got to come off. And then we have these linkages. Oh, let's see, which linkage is it? This one right here. Let's start taking it apart. Okay, if you guys can see, there's this little plastic pin thing, or clip. Just gotta flip this up and get out of the way. Be careful, because it's fragile. And then it should just be able to slide out from the back. Just like that. And then you can kind of, I guess, just let it stay, because this is staying here on the motor. All right. Let's see what else. All right, there's another one down below here. The same kind of plastic linkage as this thing. Kind of snaps over the shaft there. There's also one down here. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's holding that spring. So I'm gonna try to get my finger in there and flip it back. Probably gonna have to use the pliers. It's a little tiny spring too. Let me get down in here with this. These little plastic things, easy to break too. These little clips, come on. Now I just gotta get that spring out of there. One little hairline, little tiny spring. Come on now, there we go. All right, right there. So that shaft and that little tiny spring right there, they go on that down below. So all that's gonna come off with the carburetor now. Let's see. Ah, we have a plug over here on this side. See that little plug? That's gotta come off. And then it should wiggle its way. Be careful of this gasket right there. Don't rip that and break that all apart. Okay, the part that I need to get to, the float is up inside here. So it feeds the gas in the top, and then the float is down inside here. We'll take this apart and I'll show you. It's underneath here. All right, this is a Walbro LTB, left barrel, right barrel. So whatever that tells you. Let's see what else we got here. Walbro logo. There's the part number, I think LTB15. LTB15. So let's get it over there into the bucket and get the bottom of this thing taken off and see what that needle is looking like and where the seat, where the needle goes, is looking like. I want to make sure that we get spray it a little bit. Don't let any of that stuff get down into the carb itself. Looks like we have some star drivers, these four right here. Let's start with those. Now there's a gasket in between what I'm getting ready to take apart, the lower, the bowl. Right here, there's a gasket in here. So let's see if we're loose. Yeah, it looks like we're loose right now. I'm gonna tip this up the way it sits on the mower. Losing all that gas there. I'll bring this down. You know what, I'll probably have to take this off too. Yep. Spin that up out of the way. All right, let's just leave it this way. Okay, here's the bowl. The bowl looks fine. I'll set that over here. I don't see any crazy wear. Looks clean inside there. Here's the float. So the problem, let's see, see that float right there? And the needle sits there. So let's take that off. And of course you got to be very careful, because you take that off, that needle's going to try, the needle's going to try to get away. So I'll angle it your way so you can see. There's a little pin right here. I've got to pull out. All right, and push this through. Get that pin out and be careful. Hold all this together. All right, because that needle is going to come out now. There it is. See, the needle just sits there. I can slide this on and off. Just be careful. I'm trying to leave it in the same position, but what I'm looking for is this right here. This is where it needs to sit. This whole area right here sits flat inside there and shuts off the fuel supply. And when it does that, it'll stop the gas. But right now it's not working. It's not seating all the way. So set this over here. And it sits inside of this little body inside here. All right, it sits right down in there. I'm gonna get my light, shine down in there, see if we can see anything. No. I doubt you can see in there, but to me, that looks really clean. I don't know why I would not be seating. I mean, it looks really clean inside there. So basically what the needle does, I'm gonna take this needle off of the float. Like I said, it just sits there. And as the gas comes in, it just bounces up and down. Obviously you guys know that stuff, but it closes, it's supposed to close that. I'll take this needle off and drop it down in there, because what it's supposed to do is it gets in there and closes that off. And it seems to be functioning right. So, for some reason, it's just getting excess gasoline in there. I'm gonna have to look at this, at the point of this, the tip of this, in my with the magnifying glass and see what's going on, and also down inside there. Because if this is not sitting in there right, that's why I'm getting too much excessive fuel coming through the carburetor. So I'm gonna go look at it under my magnifying glass. All right, I'll be back. All right, well, let me tell you what I did after further inspection. I looked at that needle underneath a magnifying glass, and you can tell at the point of the let's see if I can show it to you. At the point of, it's gonna be very difficult for you guys to see this. It was hard for me to see it too, but at the very point, you can see it's wore down. It's not straight line like a cone shape at the top. It's more like concave shape at the top. So it's probably letting, that's where my problem is. I'm getting fuel bypass around because it's not seating fully all the way around. So the problem is I can't buy just a new needle anymore. That's most unfortunate. These things, you know, as far as the hours that I have on this machine, 3,800, for this to even be functioning right now as it is, a lot of the guys will say, well, that's just unheard of. So what are we gonna do? Well, let me tell you, look at that. Got a brand spanking new carburetor, same model or same brand. It's a Walbro. Oh, something else that I found too. Okay, check this out. So this linkage right here, this is the, oh boy, I gotta remember to put this back the right way. Okay, here's the choke. Now you see this choke, it's supposed to move nice and freely. Well, it's getting stuck right there. I didn't notice that until I started playing with this thing. It won't close easy. See how it's staying open? You can see it right there. And this, just look at all the play in the shaft right here. So think about all the vibration over the last how many years. Look at that. I mean, that's really moving there. So it's not closing like it should all the way, that choke. It's like bound up, and it's not bound up here. This is all free and clear. It's bound up right here. So for $300, it's what these cost now. Look at this. Moves nice and free, easy. Closes all the way. There's that slop that you see there is just this little fitting, but it's not the main shaft. Like this one, was the main shaft. It was all loose and floppy. So, look at that. Comes with a brand new gasket. A heat gasket that goes against the motor, and I'll show you that. And a brand new gasket that goes over here on the air cleaner side. It's a complete match. Look at that. So, what I need to do, there's this part that I need to take off. The spring and this linkage right here. So I'll take these two off. And unfortunately, this one fell out, but it goes into that hole right there. So all I'm gonna have to do is match it up. And I gotta take that, oh boy, that rivet piece. Oh, there's one right here, okay. So I'm just gonna put it through there. This one's metal, that one looks like it's some poly or something. But that's where it goes. It kind of weasels its way up in there. So I'm gonna do that right now. Take that off. Set that aside. And put this right here. Come on. And then this. Wiggles all around and pulls down and come on back here. There we go. See, now they're both in right there. All right, I think that's all I have. I'm gonna put the bottom of this back on. I'll just keep this around, this one, for spare parts. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the rest of it back together, the bowl, and I'll just put this in a box and put it on the shelf for spare parts, just in case I need it or there's a friend that needs these, you know, anything off of this. But there's some good parts here. These little units right here are the solenoids. You regulate the high and low idle, I believe. So there's some parts there, some internal parts right here. So we'll just hold on to this and we're gonna go get this one installed, and I'm gonna show you that right now. Let's go. All right, right here, that's the heat sink, or the heat guard. And it's supposed to come off like that. And I'm definitely gonna replace it because it comes with a new one. You can see this one's kind of ripped right here. So it comes with a new one in the kit. And this is the kit right here. So we have brand new heat sink. It's the same on both sides. I keep saying heat sink. It's not a heat sink. It's the it keeps the heat down at the point of contact with the engine. And then here's a gasket that's gonna go on at the end. I also bought, remember that little thing that I broke right here? I broke off right here was the that little closer deal. Look at this, they want $6 for these things. This little tiny bushing throttle. Let's see what this thing really is. So that is $6 right there, you guys. It's a little plastic deal. Yep, $6. And it goes right here. So basically what it does is this goes through here. When it's all installed, and this little thing slides and closes and snaps over top of it, so it doesn't back itself away. See that? Made out of plastic, easily breakable, especially underneath all that heat. When you have to go mess with something, it becomes brittle. So when you have to flip this off of here, guess what? It cracks easily. So now, before I put this on, I want to show you there's a plug here and a plug here. This one goes in straight. That's this little fella right there. And then this one goes in from the bottom, which is this one over here. So those are the first two things we're going to get on. This is for the fuel intake. And this right here. That's where the connection for the choke goes. All right, so first things first, get these plugs plugged in. Get it all lined up. It's tough to get this, your hand underneath there. Probably blocking your view, but. Okay, got the bottom one in. Here's the side one. Come on, get in there. Oh boy, don't tell me they changed something. Come on. Oh, okay, it works. See, there's that little fella right there that fell down. Okay, that remains here. All right, so it's sitting there. Now it's got to slide it back. And it pushes tight up against that bushing, and it won't. When I put the air cleaner on is when everything pulls itself tight. So we're good to go here. I just got to hook up these linkages. So this is our choke. And I believe that one we're going to do last. So the one down below is what we have to do first. So sorry if you can't get in here and see this. I kind of want you to be able to see what I'm doing down here, but it's hard. Working with my left hand under here. All right, that one's in. Now I have to work that spring back in there. That spring is tough because it does not want to. Did I get it? Oh, I got in the wrong spot. Let's move it. Come on now, get home. Oh, I got it, okay. Good. All right, now this one down here, I need a light. Let me get my light. All right, so that little, see this little black flipper deal right here? I'm gonna point it out to you. Right here, see this little black? It's the same as this one up here on top, except it's just reversed. So when that shaft goes through there, this clips back on and holds it in place. And again, sorry, you're not gonna be able to see. There it goes. You see that? It's holding back on that shaft real nice now. The spring is back in place. And that is the throttle control. Throttle right there. All right, let's do the choke control. Right now, the choke I have in, it was full choke position. That's full choke. So we'll just leave it in full choke and I'll hook it up that way. These things are real squirrely until they get locked down into position. All right, I gotta bring throttle down or choke down. There we go. All right, slide the top through and then tighten it up, button it up closed. Right there. All right, watch, I'm gonna operate the choke right now. This thing should fly open and close, see that? And it closes all the way, perfect. Okay. Now we need fuel line. Fuel line's back in, fuel is off. Get that clamp in place. Get this air cleaner. Can't forget this hole right here. Is this, I think it's a bypass for the head bypass. And we have to put in our new, what did I do with it? Our new, all right, so there's the hole right there on top. That's where this hole goes. So this line right up. Like that, and that's the gasket in between the air cleaner, and then we'll make the final hookup. I can't wait to get this thing started. Boy, I hope this fixes the problem. I'm gonna be out $300 and super bummed if it's not, but I'm with all utmost confidence I'm saying this is the problem. I'm hoping so. Now I'm going to crisscross pattern these for some reason. I don't know. It's just a habit from putting old head gaskets back together and stuff. Not going to go fully tight yet until I get them all snug. And then I'll give them a little bit of pressure. Last one here. And you know what I'm going to do too is I'll hit the throttle before I get it started and make sure. All right, crisscross. So I'll hit the throttle and make sure that the linkage is clear and moving good. All right, let's get this bypass in there. It just pushes in. You got to kind of squeeze it a little bit. That's good there. Boy, this thing needs to be washed. All right, let's check the throttle right now. It's full throttle right now. All right, we're tight. Let's pick our tools up. I'll get these other two on the other side. Let's pick our tools up and get this thing started and see what happens, all right? All right, we're gonna give this a shot. I have the garage door open. The fuel is off, I'm gonna turn it on. We're gonna choke it. Hopefully the battery's not dead. Choke is on, we'll go half throttle. Let's turn the fuel on. Let's crank on it, see what it does. Running half throttle. I see some smoke coming out. That's not normal. It's idling. It's actually idling, you guys. All right, smoke is going away. I'm gonna look for some leaks. Don't see any leaks. It's idling. Let's see if it can take some throttle.
Boy, I hear a knock. I hear a nasty knock in there.
Did you guys hear that knock? Oh man, there's a nasty knock in there. Let's try it one more time. We'll start it up. That knock does not sound good. I would hate to have to buy a new motor right now. Golly. But I know I'm close. I mean, we've been getting so many hours out of this thing, but like I said, I'm trying to limp it through one more. Look, it's not leaking. It's running at low idle, which it was not doing before. I think we got that problem fixed, but I hope there's not another problem with the with that knock. So I'm gonna get the oil changed. Hopefully it's not a knock. I'm gonna turn it on again because I didn't hear any kind of knocking in the fall last year. So I think we did all right. I'll keep you updated on what this motor does because this thing's gonna get put through some hard hours again this summer. It's gonna be running a good 40 hours at full throttle. Like it does every week. At least we got a brand new carburetor, right? You know, I should get in there and run around down the driveway. So I'm going to do that. So we will talk to you in just a bit.